What are you afraid of? The dark? Heights? Things that go bump in the night? Whatever it is that sends a shiver down your spine, we all get scared. But have you ever stopped and wondered, what actually is fear? Why do we get so scared? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
Every single one of us is afraid of something, whether we like to admit it or not. You might be arachnophobic if you're scared stiff by the sight of a spider. Or maybe you suffer from globophobia, the fear of balloons. Whatever it is that causes your blood to run cold, it all starts with your amygdala, two almond-shaped bundles of neurons deep inside the brain. They help us process memories, make decisions, and yes, spark emotions like, say, fear. Whenever you see something that scares you, like a big hairy spider or a big red balloon, your amygdala sends a signal to other sections of your brain, telling it to release hormones like adrenaline to heighten your senses and make you feel, well, afraid. This reaction is called our fight, flight, or freeze response. Once the amygdala alerts the rest of your brain to danger, you react almost instinctually by either fighting the danger, running away from it, or freezing in place. It doesn't matter if you're scared of a pop quiz or a prowling panther, your brain will still trigger your fight, flight, or freeze responses, just maybe with slightly different results. Okay, so that's what's going on inside our body whenever we get scared, but why? What's the reason we're scared of things in the first place? Well, for us humans, there are five basic ways our brains learn to be scared of certain things. Direct and indirect association, fear transference, intrusion, and inheritance. Direct association is more straightforward. That's when someone has had a bad experience that causes a strong fear, like being bitten by a dog. Indirect association is where some of the more unusual fears might come from, like, say, balloons. Maybe a big balloon popped when you were little and scared the living daylights out of you. If it scared you enough, it might leave behind a lingering fear of balloons, even though they're not actually very dangerous at all, just really loud when they pop. Fear transference happens when someone passes their fear along to you. Maybe your mom is deathly afraid to fly. It might cause you to develop a fear of flying yourself. Instructional fear is similar, where we might read or learn about a threat that makes our hair stand on end. Maybe you read about something in the news, or see something in a movie that causes you to develop a new fear. And last but not least is inherited fear, which are things we're afraid of that get passed down through our family through the decades. So, why do we get scared? Well, as it turns out, for a lot of different reasons. Fear is a complex emotion caused by lots of different things, from our own experiences to those of our cave ancestors a long time ago. So, if you or someone you know is scared of something that might seem a little strange, remember, fear works in funny ways. Just ask someone with hippopotamonstrosesquipedaliaphobia, the fear of long words. That's just cruel.